Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to connect to SQLITE and display data in a list view in JavaFX. We'll be using IntelliJ for IDE, SQLITE for database, and SceneBuilder for our UI design. Alright, let's start. I downloaded SQLITE from SQLITE.org. I got version 3.36. I sourced the SQLITE JDBC from this GitHub copy, version 3.36 as well. And for this demo, I just created a new database and create a table with just 4 fields. Also inserted sample data as well, but you may use what you have. Open IntelliJ, then new project. We're using OpenJDK 16, then name it as account list. And here we are. Let's start with renaming our fxml file. Let's call it accountlist.fxml. Good. Now we go to SceneBuilder and design our UI. Open project and look for accountlist.fxml sample. There you go, open. First, stream of this grid pane and look for pane and just drag it down. Now we just need to resize this to 301 by 334. Next, we need a list view. Just drag it here. Adjust the size as well to 223. Good. We just need to reposition it to 49. By 76. Change the effect to drop shadow. Next, we need a label. Just drag it over there. Just line it up and resize this. Set text as list of accounts. Set alignment as center. And set pan size to 18. Set FX ID as account list view. And then we set controller class as sample.controller. And now we save our changes. Now back to IntelliJ. You will see accountlist.fxml has been updated. Next, go to Main.java. Change the title to SQLITE JDBC connection. Adjust the stage size using what we have here. 301 by 334. Then we'll add a state case we need. Right, project structure, modules dependencies, and remove that one. Add FXML controls, base, and graphics. Open. And we need another. That is SQLITE JDBC jar. Open. Apply and OK. Next, we'll create new module info.java. We will require JavaFX.graphics, course FXML, controls, then java.sql for our JDBC connection. Opens our sample. And with this, we can now run and see how it looks like. All right, there you go. Our list is blank as expected, but it runs without any issue. Close this. We will now create a new class to handle our database connection. We will use a typical way to connect. And SQLITE is one of the most basic. We just need to form our URL. It is basically JDBC colon SQLITE colon, followed by the pull path and database name. It is the actual location where you save your database. This one here, that's our database. You can use terminal 2 to get the exact path. Copy this path. Then here, just paste it. Add the database name, and that's all you need. Next, we add a try and catch. Then set the return value for our DB connection. SQLite does not require a user and password. We just need a URL. That's how simple it is. Let's put a note. Once it's connected, it will be printed once it's connected. You will see it in the console. Then, set here your return value. And now our database connection is set and ready to use. With that, we are ready to code and work in our controller. And here, we start with annotating the list view using the FX IDs we set. This one here. List view string account list view. Then we want to preload this list view with values. So we're going to implement initializable interface. Import this. There you go. And then use the initialize method. Just set and import the parameters. Next, we're going to utilize our database connection class to establish database connection. Just the new instance of that class. Import this as well. Get DB connection. Remember this method. While we're here, we need to import statement and result cell as well. We need it later. We're going to build our SQL query. Just a basic one. And we can do it here in SQLite and check the output as well. Select name, username from account. Just copy the select statement. Then paste it here. We'll need try and catch as well. Set our create statement for our result set and execute our SQL statement using connect query value. We need to handle the query result once the SQL statement executed. We will use while loop here. It is capable and it allows us to handle multiple rows. We're going to use two variables to handle the values of name and username. This will make our code more readable and manageable, as I prefer them over single letter codes. Next, we will have another variable to handle the concatenated value of name and username. I want to display them in a list view. It will look like this, gender unknown, but we need to tweak it with space so it will make sense. You just need to update the concatenation, add a double quotes, put a backslash to serve as escape character to allow double quotes as part of the value, else it will error out. And finally, add list out in account list view that get items to populate the list with the current row and eventually, of course, all rows from the query result. Okay, now let's run this. And there you go. We successfully connected to SQLite, then displayed the result here after we queried to the database table account. And also, we concatenated name and username, then displayed them as a single value. Alright, now I'm going to show you how to modify this to look like what we have in the screenshot and the thumbnail. We just need to go back to main.java. We set init style as stage style.utility to remove the maximize and minimize button. And your states will have only close button. And here, in Scene Builder, we adjust the style and effects. Change the color, set effects to drop shadow, send font color to white, then adjust it to your preference. Move this, adjust this a little bit, adjust the font size as well, save your changes, take note of the font size, update the size of the stage, comment out the set title, and then run it. And there you go, the title has been removed. And now you only have a close button. Alright, this is all I have. If you have any question, just leave it in a comment. Thank you for watching.